A dielectric slab is partially introduced between the plates of a capacitor as shown below. So what is the capacitance of the system? And here, so one sentence is missing. This dimension of the plates is B. This dimension is B. So the total length of the plate is L. We can split this into two capacitors. One is dielectric capacitor, this is dielectric capacitor, and this is air capacitor. Separation between the plates of each capacitor is D. But area of the dielectric capacitor will be C here. This is X, right? This is X. This is B, XB. Area of this is XB. Area of air capacitor is L minus X into B. Remember this? Now, so this is the diagram. Area of the dielectric capacitor is, area of the dielectric capacitor is XB. Area of the air capacitor is L minus X into B. Separation between the plates is D only. So we can split this capacitor into two capacitors and they are in parallel. So one is dielectric capacitor and another is air capacitor. Now they are in parallel. Okay, so the effective capacity, will be between C, A and B, C dielectric plus C air. So air capacity plus dielectric capacitor. K times of epsilon naught A, what is the area of this? XB divided by D plus no K, so epsilon naught area L minus X into B divided by D. So what you can take common, epsilon naught B by D you can take common. You will get KX plus L minus X. Or else, still you can simplify epsilon naught B by D into K minus 1 into X plus L. So this is the effective capacity.